known as a fez, named after a town in Morocco where 980 AD 50,000 Hebrew Israelites, that they refer to as Jews and Christians, including women and children, were brutally murdered by Muslim Moors and Arabs. Don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourself. I'm not making this history up. I'm telling you the history of the Moors are filthy. They enslaved us many times. This is why they say they're not so-called black people. Now, as the streets ran red with the blood of our people, it was the Moors that did this. It was Muslim Moors. And now you simple-ass black Americans talking about you want to be a Muslim? Do you really know the history of Islam and what it's done to your people, man? Do you know about the Arab slave trade? Do you really want to be a Moor knowing that Moors done this? These were Muslim Moors that did this, and Arabs. So the red fez symbolizes the slaughter of our people by Muslim Moors in that town of Fez. And then, after they murdered us and our blood was running in the street, they dipped their fezes in our blood. Don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourself. So the Masons still wear the red fez, adorned with the Islamic crescent symbol. And many Moors practice masonry in the mosque today. And among the oaths of the Masons, the Moors, and the Masonic Shriners organization is one that says, "And may Allah, the God of Arab, Muslim, and Mohammedan, the God of our fathers, support me in the entire fulfillment of the same. Amen, amen, amen." And you know I'm not lying. And you probably wonder how I know this. So the fez derives its name from the place where it first was manufactured commercially. The city of Fez in Morocco, by you no good dirty Moors. And some say the red color is a mineralization of the color of blood. And these Muslim Moors' victories over the Hebrew Israelite Jews and the Christians and Africans. See, the city of Fez formerly had a monopoly of the manufacture of the Fez headdress because it controlled the juices of the berry used to color the fezes.